What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Chuckfinle here with us play Sonic Generations Part 11. We are here in Crisis City, and we're going to start the challenges for Crisis City. I would hope in this video to do both the Crisis City and, for the challenges, Crisis City and, what's the Rooftop Run. But Crisis City, the challenges are very difficult, especially, you know, everything's just going to get difficult. You know, the farther we go on, that's just, you know, the way most games work. But for the game, for the levels here in the modern era, things are definitely going to get a lot harder, by themselves, whether it was game-wise or not. Just because the levels are more detailed and there's just more things that you have to deal with that you wouldn't have to deal with in the modern, or the classic and the Dreamcast era. But this level in particular is going to be very difficult. The challenges in it will be very difficult, as well as this doppelganger race. This doppelganger race, I've never had an easy time with it. I'm thankfully doing a little bit better than I usually do. Well, not now, but I can sometimes jump on them worms to get to this upper section and save a little bit of time. But this doppelganger race is very difficult for me for both modern and classic Sonic, especially once I get to the end of it, end of this level. It gets very difficult. Thankfully, the doppelganger seems to have trouble in a lot of the areas where most people would have trouble at, but not nearly as much trouble as the player can have. Like, I mean, you can have, if you watched part five. There you go. You can just see how far away that the doppelganger has gotten. So that means he went on a faster path than I did, and was able to gain quite a bit of time on me. So you have to be very careful about that. You always have to watch the doppelganger. You know, watching the doppelganger, it won't stop him from. Oh crap! Jumped over that spring again. Watching the doppelganger, it won't help you. But it will kind of give you a sense of where he is, so that you can kind of hurry if you need to. And you definitely need to, especially in this one. I mean, he can very easily. Oh crap! Don't tell me I'm gonna have trouble in this section. If sometimes I will have trouble in this section, I won't be able to get through it. Like I, crap, I'm just gonna go ahead and kill myself and hope I can make it next time. It seems like the doppelganger will be in the same exact spot he was when you hit the checkpoint, which is good. But because he was so close to me and I'm on a different path than him, and he seems to be able to gain more ground on me through here, that's not very useful for me to keep starting in this section. But, you know, once I get past here, keep going this way, seems like I gained quite a bit of time on him through this section. So hopefully that will be the case again. You know, I can stay on a higher, more easier to go on path. Now that was that. Oh, thought I was about to die again. Now that path that I took with the springs on the top of that building, that was actually a red star ring path that I will show off later on. Oh, don't tell me I'm stuck here. Okay, what was the point of going up there? Other than just waste my time? Perhaps a red star ring, but yeah, that really wasted my time. Wow. I had a pretty good lead going there too. That sucks. But anyway, you know, that's just what you have to do. You have to be very careful about that kind of stuff. You always have to be watching. You know, you have to always have to make sure that you don't go on the slow paths. You got to make sure that you don't take damage in certain areas. Those are just things that you have to do. Not waiting for sections when you don't have to, you know. Crap, come on. Alright, well, he seems to know where he's going. And this is an area where he can. What the hell? Now, he can have trouble in this section because the tornado won't be like the tornado is for you. You know, this was whenever the doppelganger was made, it was at a different time with the tornado. And so it will always be different for him. So you can actually gain a few seconds there if you need to, and you know, it's definitely useful if you can. I'm doing a little bit better this time. Yeah, this is a very, very difficult level, Crisis City is. I mean, you can just get stuck there going through it the normal way, not, you know, forget the challenges or the doppelganger race. You can just get stuck there by yourself. And in this one, you have unlimited lives, and that one, in the normal level, before, like playing it through for the first time or just any time, you know, you have a set number of lives, and if you lose all of those lives, you know, you're going to be in trouble. What the hell? Come on. I don't know why, but every time I get underneath this truck, it seems to stop me. Like, I can't move. For some reason, and I don't know why. But I'm doing okay, I guess. I'm gaining a little bit of time. I don't know any really good shortcuts going through here, but I just know how to get to the end. Without dying. Okay, that's right. You have to stay on top of the truck. Come on. There we go. Come on. I don't see the doppelganger yet, so I'm still good. Oh, shoot. Come on. There we go. All right. Good. Very good. Don't even care about the rank. As I've said before, ranks do not matter to me in this. All I'm here for is just the challenge win and the note that you get for beating that one. But that's just only one of many of, I guess, four more challenges that we have to do. I think I did Metal Sonic when I did these challenges, or not Metal Sonic, but Modern Sonic when I did these challenges the first time. And now you have to head up here, past Silver, and this is where the rest of the challenges are. Oh, goodness. Oh. No. Alright, well, I guess I did. Okay, yeah, that's right. The turn order would have been this one. Okay. Vector through the storm. Call for a vector by. Okay. Nah, I'll just read it Call for Vector to get by spots you can't pass and get to the goal in time. Alright, so thankfully I did do that signpost one. Yeah, I remember that challenge now. It wasn't too bad. I was just sitting here thinking that it was going to be really bad. But then I noticed the dead bell there, so. Alright. So you can see there, Vector has a line that you have to line up so that you... for him to throw you. You obviously have to make sure that the line is pretty precise, or you won't be able to make it, but you saw the line, the angle, I guess, and he can throw you straight up, or either straight up in the air, or straight across the screen, and anywhere in between those two points. Which is always useful. You can always use the rings to line up. Oh, crap. Threw it way too high. You can always use the any rings around that to help you out, and that was just a waste of time. I shouldn't have waited for that. And sadly, it does always start you pointing up, so if you have to go across the screen... Oh, dear. Okay, so... Vector cannot take damage, but he can, you know, if he does get hit by something, he does disappear. It's not seem... Wow, really? You have very limited movement once Vector actually throws you, so you have to be very careful. And those, points, spheres from which debuted in Sonic, or that debuted in... Spring Yard Zone. What the crap? I don't know if I'm supposed to go back up or if I can go this way, or what I'm supposed to do. I guess I'll just go this way, either way. That was probably too dangerous, but it seemed to get me past a lot of BS, so I'm happy. But this dang tornado, it's definitely a pain. Alright, there we go, okay. That's pretty good. I'm happy with that result. Alright, man, that challenge wasn't too hard. It's just the tornado at the end is the biggest thing. That's the worst obstacle that there is, and past that, everything else is pretty easy. You don't have to worry about too much getting in your way past the tornado, and the tornado isn't that difficult to... Well, yeah, actually it is pretty difficult to get around, but I'm just going to wait here for the note, but you just have to wait, you just have to time it. That's the best you can do, is just time it. Flame Shield challenges, Flame Shield to reach the goal in time and obtain the Flame Shield skill. So, I kind of guess this would be in Crisis City being the flame, or the fire level for this game, and the Flame Shield would work better here than in any other zone. And so the Flame Shield might not be as fun or as easy as I thought it would be. But we'll see. So that's the exact same thing you could do in the original, or in Sonic 3. Or Sonic 3 and Knuckles. And it would protect you from fire just like it does. You just have to make sure that you don't lose the fire shield, and just like with the thunder shield challenge, there will be plenty of fire shields for you to use, and you can use the mid-air dash to act as a boost, which will definitely work and help you get across a wide open area very quickly and very easily. However, you do have to be careful, especially with this type of challenge. There will be a lot of open holes that can catch you out. You know, so you don't want to go around continuously dashing. And even in regular levels, you still always want to be careful. You know, all the time. You never want to just say, oh, okay, you know, well, I'll just continuously dash, and you know, I won't have to worry about anything. Well, yeah, you do actually have to worry about anything. And it does, the dashing does play largely on your angle, so you have to time it just right while you're jumping around. You just can't, you know, jump and hit the dash and hope to make it. You have to always be precise with where you're going to jump and the height and everything. And it's not as difficult as I'm making it sound. You know, it's actually pretty easy. It doesn't take too much getting used to it. It's just if you played with the fire shield or the flame shield in Sonic 3 and Knuckles, like I did a whole bunch, then, you know, it's very easy. And they actually made this one a lot smoother and a lot better to use. The flame shield in the original was just a good fire repellent, and that's about it. You really didn't use the mid-air dash feature all that much, or at least I didn't. But in this one, it would actually seem pretty fun. Quick Trip to Paradise. The way that sounds out could be a Sonic R theme, Sonic R theme, or music. Sonic R themes are kind of titled like that. Ring Time Challenge, use Ring Time, and reach the goal in time to earn the Ring Time skill. So I guess we get the Ring Time skill now, but they definitely made the Flame Shield a lot funner and easier to use in this game. It makes you go a lot farther, and it makes you go, you know, it'll get you up to speed pretty quickly. Just the problem is you don't have the double jump, and I find the double jump is a lot more easier, or well, not easier, but a lot more fun. Oh, okay. Yeah, I forgot about that. I momentarily forgot about what we were doing. Yeah, this is going to be a pain in the butt to do. This level being what it is, and the way it's set up and everything. And you do only have 5, so just keep that in mind as you go along. You only want to use it in areas that the game tells you to, and that would be, you know, the green, the blue circles with the exclamation points in them. It's even the rings travel downhill. That's okay, I guess. And remember, you do lose 80 rings every time you take damage, so do keep that in mind as you go along. Oh dear, really? I guess I should have used it there, but I was trying to kind of, I was going to wait until a section like this when the game actually told me to do it instead of there, but I guess, you know, it's branching out and thinking on your own rather than doing what the game tells you. But it shouldn't be too big of a setback. I've got half the rings that I need. And the key to this in doing it efficiently is just trying to get as many rings as fast as possible. You know, if there's a big group of enemies, just collect all the rings as fast as you can and don't worry about too much else. And I probably should have saved it, but, you know, hey, I'm not going to worry about it too much. I'm going to try to collect as many rings as possible. And I'm not going to worry about it. I do wish they would have given you a shield. That would have definitely made it a lot easier. And I'm sure there's going to be some, what, flame worms? Nothing, okay. So I guess you could use it in that last section, as long as you made sure you got all of the enemies around you first. Alright, looks like I dropped frames really rapidly again, so I do apologize. I'm going to cut and take a look at it. Well, maybe not. Last time I dropped frames really rapidly, it didn't seem to affect it, so unless I can tell, unless I start dropping frames really rapidly again, I won't cut. I'll just leave it like it is now and hope it isn't messed up. Alright, so that's going to dive down. That's kind of where I need to go anyway, so... Oh, 15. I need to head down here so that I can do the Modern Sonic Challenge here at the bottom. And then I'll just work my way up like I did with Classic Sonic. And we'll go ahead and change since we're here. I guess I could change while I was... Yeah, the loading times for the change is just a little bit too much. You know, it's a little bit too long for it to be a good thing to do. Power Stomp Challenge. Use your stomping skills to reach the goal before time runs out to get the Power Stomp skill. Huh. Wonder what the Power Stomp will be. Probably just a wider radius of damage that you can do to the enemies. Which, I mean, it, you know, isn't that impressive. Because the stomp isn't something that I really use to clear out a wide range of enemies. I find the homing attack to be a little bit easier. Now, if I had a homing attack speed-up skill, that would be nice. But I don't believe they do. Yeah, you know, that you saw those Iblis biters there. That's about all that's useful for. And I find that, you know, stomping in a section like that and then boosting into whatever enemies that are in front of you is a lot easier. And you just stomp, then boost, and then just boost again. Or just use the homing attack, like as I said before. You know, it's not that difficult to realize, or even to, you know, it's not something that they needed to really work on or give you, but I guess it's okay if you like using those types of things, but, you know, I'm more of a Sonic Unleashed player. I play this game and Sonic Colors like Sonic Unleashed, and so all of the new stuff that was not in Sonic Unleashed, I'm not a big fan of. You know, I don't take to it with open arms. I'm always a little bit skeptical of it, just because I don't see the need in it, really. Yeah, I mean, this is useful, and I can see the uses of it, but I just, you know, like I said, with the homing attack, you know, if they made it where you could use the homing attack a little bit faster, and this is a prime example of wasting time to gain time. You know, there was no reason. There was no reason for me to have wasted so much time trying to go after that 10 seconds. All I did was just waste a whole bunch of time and messed up my arc, or not my arc, but the line going into jump, and which caused me to die. There was no reason for that. You know, that 5 seconds, that's fine. That's not out of the way. But that 10 seconds is very out of the way, and there's no reason to go after it. I mean, like a section like that with those two Ibla spiders, you just use the homing attack. You know, you stomp the first one, and then you use the homing attack on the second one. Nothing special. You know, neither of them hit you. And even there, you know, you don't have to use the stomp move. All you have to do is just use the homing attack. You know, there again with those takers. Just use the homing attack. It's not that, it's not a problem. I guess I said that before, but you know, it's not really. And I never thought about using the balloons to use the staff. Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. That's what stomping on the balloons gets you dead. Shit. Ah, sorry about that. Okay. I guess I'll just wait for, I'll just go over here and wait for the balloons to respawn. There we go. Okay. Yeah, see, I mean, the crap. The homing attack works a lot better than the stomp. For height. Yeah, see, there you go. All you gotta do is just use the boost. But you know, I'm not really ragging on it. It's a nice skill. I wouldn't waste the points on it. But you know, if you just want to mess around with it, you know, it's something to use. You could kind of tell how the enemies were placed in groups specifically for this challenge. There's not too many areas like that in the game by itself. You know, the most you'll get is maybe 2-3 enemies clumped together. And the only places I can think of those with those types of enemies would be. Seaside Hill, and you know, even then, there's not a whole bunch of them all clumped together that you really have to worry about. But you know, anyway, I'm just almost complaining, and you know, like I said, it's an okay skill for what it is. I personally just wouldn't use it with my playstyle, but anyway. Time-wise, I'm doing okay. I don't know if I will be able to get to. It really just depends on if I can beat these last few challenges. If I will even be able to do anything in Rooftop Run, I highly doubt I will. I'm just rapidly running out of time. He's using the different skills or the different tricks. Oh crap! Okay, I'll just follow him. I think that's why he's a little bit faster anyway. And I don't think any of the other tricks actually give you any more boost than you know just doing the forward tricks. I haven't tested it out, but I don't think so anyway. And you can see whoever either made the program for the doppelganger or is actually doing the doppelganger is actually really good at this level, and that this can be a problem if you're not careful, especially if you're not good at the level, which they did definitely make a lot of improvements over the original by far. You know, it's obviously not as buggy and it's not as glitchy and not as filled with BS as the original, so that's a step up in the right direction. But they seem to take the hardness of that level and then just triple it. Like, you know, I mean, there's just so many different little things in this level that are so very difficult that seem to fit with the original idea of the level. You know, like maybe due to time constraints or something, they couldn't make the original level quite so difficult. Well, you know, they definitely got their wish now. And it's, you know, it's not overly difficult, this level. It's just, I would say it's more classic Sonic. You know, modern Sonic seems to work well with this level. Classic Sonic, however, does not. And I blame that, you know, on just Classic Sonic's movement style not working with this level. You know, this level is was designed for modern Sonic on a next-gen console, and the next-gen console, it doesn't matter, but just modern Sonic and his moveset. It was never intended for a 2D classic side-scrolling section, and you know it doesn't work. Even though they did a good job with it, and it's almost playable, except for the tornado at the end. I would say that's the worst thing about it. But you know, I mean, that they did a good job on it. I'll definitely give them that. They took a 3D only level and done a pretty good job of making it convince itself that it belongs in a classic Sonic game. I guess you could pretty much say that. That's about, you know, the biggest thing I could say for it is just that Sega wanted the level to believe that it actually belonged in one of those games. And he is right up next to me. That stinks. Okay, so you do actually gain more score for the other. Oh crap, that's not what I needed. For the other tricks you can do, you gain more of a score bonus for them, even though they take a little bit longer to do. Which is that's nice. You know, I would say that the forward tricks are for doing trick challenges or trying to get the trick-based trophy. If you wanted to get more score for them, however, I would suggest doing some of the other tricks, now that I just figured that out. Well, time-wise, I don't know. Like I said, it really depends on if I can get through here quickly. I may try to do a handful of the challenges in, okay, I should just fall down there. I may try to do a handful of the challenges in the modern, or the for Classic Sonic in Rooftop Run, Race to Win. I believe that's the theme for Sonic Rivals 2, if I'm not mistaken. Switcheroo, put your brain to the test by hitting switches to get to the goal in time. Okay, that's not too difficult. At least it didn't look like it in the title card thing, the title card picture. But those can be pretty deceiving, but a lot of the times, I don't know, a lot of the times they're not. Sega seem to want to make it look more difficult than it actually is. Okay. Okay, so the switch that was blocking all of these guys from shooting at me, I just opened up. And now they're all going to shoot at me. That stinks. Okay, it's just that multiple path thing. I've seen other games try to use something like this, where they tell you to hit switches, maybe not in a certain order, but all you have to do is just hit the switches, and then you can open up different paths. I don't know why some of these switches aren't working. Oh, I guess that lets me go over here. Crap. That stinks. And that's why we don't boost. We always look ahead to where we're going before we boost. Alright, so this section, not too difficult. Not nearly as difficult as I thought it would be. They don't seem to shoot at you too fast. Perhaps boosting it. As Omo Chow said, you know, you have to flip the switches in order to open up different paths, and you know, perhaps boosting on that first section will help you stay on this upper path up here instead of going along this slower section. Of course, you know, both the upper and the lower section will lead to here, so it doesn't really matter either way. You still have to deal with this. Oh, okay, I guess one side opens or turns the switches on, the other side closes them. And then it's your job to figure out which side does what, I guess. Unless you're just supposed to get to the top up here and... Okay. I definitely don't care for challenges like this. This is just a pain, an unnecessary pain in the butt. Come on. That's about the only way to get some of these switches to work. Alright, so that opens that so that you can get down here. You don't want to boost, or you'll fall and... Okay. Shoot. Come on. I think I figured out. Crap. If I can quit hitting that switch, I think I can figure out a... crap, I forgot to jump. Why aren't these other switches turning on for? I would like to know that. There we go. Come on. Okay. There we go. And there's the gold ring mocking me. Yeah. Okay. I don't know, that's why I'm sitting here quietly, because I don't know, I'm sitting here trying to figure out the pattern of these switches, just trying to my best not to fall. I guess, yeah, there may have been a way I could actually cheat there and cut off a good portion of the level, but I couldn't figure it out, and I would just like to get done with this. Okay, that opens that one, and this one must open that one, okay. Alright, well, I'll just head up here and hopefully dodge a lot of unnecessary crap. I must have got lucky, though. I thought I'd overshot it there for a moment. Okay. That's good. At least I didn't, mess up anymore, and at least I didn't die again. Yeah, it's just challenges like that, you know, that make Crisis City difficult and make me not like challenges. Okay. Have to go a good ways for this one. And then hopefully not fall, and then have to backtrack a good ways. I do wish they would have just given you the notes instead of having to force, instead of forcing you to chase them down like that. Blaze, piercing the flames. Call Blaze to get through the flames and get to the goal in time. Okay. And so this acts as being able to play as Blaze and Vector's challenges. This is pretty much telling you, you know, hey, you can play as Vector, or that's how you play as Vector. As I said before, you know, it doesn't really bother me either way. Okay, so she's just gonna put out the flames. And so, as her name suggests, she actually controls fire. That was in her debut game, Sonic Rush. She could control fire, and she, you know, used that to her advantage to go through the game. You could play as her in that game, and she could use the flames to her advantage, or using fire to her advantage. I hate those worms. And you really haven't seen it anywhere else. I don't remember if you could play as her in Sonic 06. I don't remember if you could actually use any fire abilities in that game. You very well might have been able to, but I can't remember right now. I'm sitting here trying not to die. I'm past the point of dying now, thankfully, but still gotta be careful. You know, this is Crisis City after all. And then you have to watch out for the flame walls and everything. And she seems to be able to go a good distance away from you, so you don't have to be right up next to the flames. But some of the flames you do. You know, it's kind of weird. I was hitting a flame earlier where it seemed like I had to be pretty close to it. Oh dear. And hopefully the takers will come back. There we go. Okay, so just like in Sonic 06, they appear again for you to use, which is always useful. Sadly, she does not actually attack enemies for you. That would be very useful. Alright. So, yeah. Just worried about the frame drop again. Alright, so I still got one more, sadly. There we go. That's one of the easiest, you know, when I like when they are easy to get to and you don't have to actually chase them down like that four-way cannon cavalcade. Go from one four-way cannon to the other to another and get to the goal before time runs out. So they will probably be in different patterns that you have to use to get around and get across, which is never fun. But you know, the four-way cannons aren't that difficult, and I don't believe you can actually take damage in them. I believe the four-way cannons debuted in Sonic Colors. Okay, yeah, I was gonna say, when they throw the spikes in, you can always tell that it's gonna be BS-y. Especially when you don't have any control over it, and you either fall down a good distance, or you just die. I believe there is actually a time limit. Oh crap, really? I could. That sucks. I guess I could jump back up there like that, couldn't I? Well, let me see if I go this way, what will happen. Nothing. Except death. Nope. Yeah, I'll just go ahead and die and start over. Not too difficult. I made that a little bit more difficult messing around there at the beginning, but I had forgotten which path I needed to take. Following the rings is definitely very helpful. I believe there's a time limit for these, but I'm not 100% sure. It didn't seem like there was, but I kind of remember there being a time limit, so you really don't have a whole lot of time to plan where you want to go and when you want to do it here. I will check with this one, see if there is actually a time limit. Okay, there is. You can see the blue, kind of like a circle where in the middle with a star. Well, that is actually the timer. You can watch the bar go, the bar drain out. Oh, crap. And that will tell you, you know, how much time you have while going through here, and I don't want to go along this path. I want to go up there with the damn rings. And I don't believe there's been a checkpoint, so I'm gonna. Yeah, you can always tell whenever the takes a while to load, means you're always gonna start back at the beginning of the level. But that is good. It doesn't seem like it's a very large time limit, but at least there is some time limit. You know, and it's okay. I would say it's probably about 5 seconds. If I'm lucky, and usually I'm not, so, crap, I don't know, I guess you have to wait for the flame, for him to start shooting the flames, but, come on, it wasn't even there where I could be hit. like that one where I won't take damage from it. Come on. Well, I'm not going to worry about going up there. I would like that ring, though. Well, I guess I'm going to have to now. Nope. Damn it. Ah, crap. Not going to cut, though. I apologize for making you sit through this, but I don't want to cut over this. I'll just get through it and get it done. Golly. Knew I should have waited for that one, but I'm impatient now. This is what these challenges do to me. I just get impatient, especially, you know, since I'm doing a Let's Play. I just want to get it done and over with. You know, I've been through this with, this is my fourth run through now, and I just want to get it over with and done. Because this should be the last one, and depending on time, I guess I'm supposed to wait for that one to come out so that I can use the homing attack on it. Oh, crap, you have got to be kidding me. That's not even... Like, what are you supposed to do there? You can't... Obviously, you can't get the recommended height to get up there. Okay. Oh, we'll try. Oh. I was going to try stomping on it, but... Since I made it, I won't do that. And now there's a checkpoint. Great. And then more of this four cannon crap. Now you can... Oh, crap, 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 crap. Now you can, just shoot yourself in the air and then fall back down to... If you run out of time, that's actually a pretty good strategy. If you're... Come on. If you are going to... dive, or, you know, if you are going to lose time in the cannon... Just like this. Oh, really? And you can't actually take damage in the cannon. Wow. Remember that thing I said about the challenges and me hating them and wishing that game developers would quit putting them in games? We won't go that route. It's just 5 seconds. It's not worth the minute it would take me for me to get back up there and then, or to even get up there and then get back to that position again once I die, so. There we go. And at least I gotta be. But I don't care about the ranks, quite honestly. I just wanna get it over with and get it done. Alright, so time-wise, sadly, I'm not going to be able to do Rooftop Run. I'll try to do the Act 1 challenges, but I will not be able to do both Act 1 and 2. I'm quickly running out of time and hard drive space, so I'm not going to be able to do it, sadly. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and try to catch this note, and then I'll just start at the top here, open your heart. So that's the main theme for Sonic Adventure 1. And I'll start up here, and just try to do, like I said, I'll just, depending on how quickly I can get through here, if I can get through here really, really, really fast, I may be able to have time to get to it, I don't know. High rise balloon climb. Use the big balloons to climb higher and higher and reach the goal in time. Yeah. I doubt it, but, you know, hey, I'll give it a shot. Either way. But, yeah, you know, either way, this will be done in one more video. You know, whether I was to quit now or quit later or, you know, I quit after this. It'll still be done in one more video, and then I can... Oh. Okay, so... One of these things. You cannot move around on the balloon while you're flying up, and they do explode after you get to a certain height, so you do want to be very careful and watchful for that. Okay. I'm talking about the balloons, I have it, and all I did was just use the balloons really quickly and then went away from them. And you obviously want to be careful bouncing around on the balloons. You cannot swing on the balloons, as I was saying, you just have to, all you can do is just sit still, which that kind of throws your movement off. While you're trying to jump up, as I said, the jumping restrictions with Classic Sonic make it very difficult to use. And then you throw in electric fences. I was fixing to say if they were going to throw me lower on in the clock tower, I was going to be pissed. And you have to watch out for these egg launchers. I believe that's what they're called, egg launchers. Throwing rockets at you. And then timing with these jumping, platforms, the moving platforms, are always fun. And this should be getting near the end. Probably all I have to do is just, I don't have to get on the clock tower and crash into the egg. Into flying battery zone again, so that's something. Come on, really? Yeah, the jumping in this game is very bad for Classic Sonic. It's almost like the game was not... The jumping ability was not meant for Classic Sonic. Like, they wanted to use it for a different character. Or maybe they just wanted to use it only for modern Sonic or something. I don't know. It's just terrible. Like, the jumping in the original games wasn't spotty at best, but... sometimes you wouldn't, but it wasn't the best, and obviously that was just due to console limitations and everything of that time. Not Sega's fault or anyone's fault, really. It's just, that's what you had to deal with consoles back then, and controls and everything like that. But, there's no excuse for the jumping ability to be so bad in this game. This is supposed to be a reimagining of Classic Sonic, not taking the jumping limitations from him in his early days and actually putting him on a next-generation console. You could make the jumping a lot better. But that's why you use the, Come on! You have got to be kidding me. But that's why you use the Thunder Shield to use the double jump so that crap like that doesn't happen. And if you jump up and to dodge those arrow chasers, the arrow cannon shots, you'll jump off the balloon, and all you'll do is just bounce off the other one underneath you, and then end up flying away and having to start the entire section over again. So there's no benefit from jumping up to dodge the shots. That's all you're gonna do. And then, if you're not lucky enough to get onto another balloon, you'll just fall and die, and that's it. Well, you won't die, but you'll fall, and you'll have to start that section over again. And there's no point to it. Now, you can bounce on top of them for whatever it's worth, but that's not usually the preferred choice. I'm sure you could actually make it work, but I don't know. The jumping seems to be like you'd end up landing way too low. And you would never make it. It seemed to be okay. I definitely won't try it, but it could be something useful. But it's just timing with platforms. I hate doing something like this and having to time on a platform. I would use the spin dash there, but I didn't remember if there was something that was going to catch me there, or if I was going to fall off the side and have to come back up that entire section again. Okay. Well, I'll give that balloon. I won't hop on top of the. Well, maybe I'll give that balloon hopping it. No. Yeah, that's what I figured happened. You know, you just end up trying to dodge the arrow cannon's shots, and then you'd end up. Just falling and dying. I guess you could take them out, you know, jump from side along the sides and then take them out, but I don't see the point in it, to be honest. Oh, come on, really? I guess I was kind of asking for that one, but, you know, that just kind of goes to show that you cannot use the... You cannot jump to avoid the arrow. Cannon's shots. Yeah. So, yeah, time-wise, definitely, unless I can get through the other ones really quickly, and I know I can't. The doppelganger race is going to give me trouble. I already know that ahead of time. I'm going to be stuck there for quite a while. So, with this one being stuck, and I don't remember the other ones, to be honest, I shouldn't get stuck on any more, but this is a big one, and the doppelganger race is a big one. You know, I've spent nearly, probably over 6 minutes on just this one challenge by itself, and doppelganger race, you know, will probably be near 3 minutes, if not a little bit over, by itself. So, oh come on, okay, there we go. That's stupid. I sit here and complain about jumping on the balloons and how it's not a good idea, and yet I continue to do it. Just because, you know, it's easy, it just gets me up in the air and continuing going higher. And, you know, maybe I'll get lucky and stay on the balloon and get all the way to the top. I doubt it, but, you know, you never know. And, you know, dodging the egg launchers isn't that difficult, the rockets on them. It doesn't take a lot to, timing-wise, you know, before the rockets. It's just when you're on the balloons. That's the biggest problem with the... Really? That's just the biggest problem with the egg launchers. The arrow cannons, however, are a different matter, and I might just try to take them out one by one as I go up. Seeing as you jump, I jumped into that one. Oh, come on. All I was able to do was just take one out. That stinks. And that one's not even a major threat, really. Or is it? I don't remember if the first one here on the left is a major one, or that one that I just killed on the right was a... now I'm going to say it's the right one. Or the left one. And if you can catch him off guard like that, you know, that's something. Come on, no. There we go. Now, put both of those out. Well, thankfully they can't... Come on, blow the damn balloons up. As you're going up. One one ring to try to go past three arrow chasers. I'm thinking very seriously about cutting until I get to the end and past that section. I don't know though. I might get a see if I can get a thunder shield and go back through it like that. And I would not view that as cheating at all. You know, this is just ridiculous going so long into this. It was nine and a half minutes. We're a little bit over right now doing this crap. There's, you know, there's no reason for it. So I'll give it one more shot. If I can't do it, that's what I'll do. I'll just get a thunder shield. I'll cut. I'll get the thunder shield. I'll come back to that section. And then, well, if I can't get a thunder shield, I'll still go back to that section once I'm past it. But if I can't get the thunder shield, I will talk about, you know, how to use it efficiently while going through here. Oh, come on. Challenges, man, I freaking hate them. Like, I don't see the fun in this. You know, there's nothing fun about this. I don't like calling things unfair, you know, like that's just, it's childish, you know, that's just the way, that's the way this is supposed to be, but why put it in the game? That's my question. You know, whether it's unfair or not, just don't put it into the game. You know, there's no reason for this crap to be in the game. I wonder when egg launchers could reload their rockets. Yeah, that would have definitely made them a lot, more potent in Sonic Unleashed. Once they shot the game's description of them, you know, once they shoot the two rockets, they're pretty much useless after that. All right. We'll just continue to go up and see how we do. Timing for these lower ones, you may be able to jump over them, but for these, there's no way. You see, once you get to that point, of course. Okay. Happy I got through with that one. And of course I gotta dive down for it. Okay, so you can tell when it kinda ends and quits being this level. Rooftop Run. Of course. Oh yeah, that's why it dove down that way, didn't it? Day now. No. Oh, you've got to be freaking kidding me. Okay. I'm just gonna forget about it right now. It's gonna be artwork, whatever one I got last. It's just gonna be the one after that one. I'm not gonna waste any more time on it. I'm sitting here just wasting time when I need to be focusing on getting past all this. Oh, well. Since I'm here, I'm gonna go ahead and do the doppelganger race, even though I know I'm gonna get stuck on it, but it'll be a little bit more convenient for me to. I just go ahead and do it while I'm here instead of having to backtrack and then go up and then, you know, come back down from going up and all that. But anyway, I really hope my audio is not bad on this, like, off or anything like that. Of course, you jump off the egg pond. I thought about that, but I had missed the initial jump. Okay, it looks like he fell. Now, with these, I guess you could call them baskets, you have to get the timing just right to jump to be able to make it. You have to jump a little bit before they actually stop, or you won't be able to gain enough height to be able to jump efficiently and then continue on, or you'll get stuck, or you'll have to fall down and go to a lower section. So you have to be very careful and always time your jumps just a little bit before, like right there. Kind of, right. Okay, that's right. You can't go along that. When they're on the inside like that, you can't actually go past those saw blades. But, you just have to kind of do a little running start and then jump, or you won't make it, across. And it's not that difficult, to learn how to do that, or even get used to it. It's actually very easy and very simple. Actually, a good idea to watch the doppelganger, just because you can actually learn quite a lot from it. A lot of the times, as I've said before, they don't really follow along the same path that you would. So maybe if you know an S rank path, or not an S rank path, an S rank path, but a Red Star ring path, which could be faster or just a shortcut in the game, you'll definitely gain a little bit of time. Oh, come on, you'll definitely gain a little bit of time on the doppelganger. But just going through just normal sections of a level, will definitely help you out. Come on, there we go. Just doing little things like that will help you out and get you along sections a little bit faster. But you want to be careful. As I've said before, the spin dash is kind of like the boost. It can get you out of trouble very easily, but it can also get you in trouble a lot easier. So you always want to be careful and watch out for those types of things. But it's a lot of the time you really can't tell that something's gonna mess you up like that. So you just kind of have to throw caution to the wind and go for it. Thankfully, I'm not doing it quite as bad as I have before in the past with this doppelganger race. I seem to gain quite a bit of time on that section that I used the spin dash on. And maybe that's what is propelling me forward and helping me out while going through here, but he's definitely catching up a lot quicker. Or maybe he's just on the clock tower, and the clock tower is, since we're going up rather than across, he's rather underneath me than right beside me. Oh, come on. There we go. Not too difficult to... Oh, really? Just what I needed. Come on, what the hell are you supposed to do through here? I can't get back to the damn... I guess you're just supposed to wait for the hands to go back where they're supposed to go. And this just lost me the damn thing. Well, maybe not. There's still a... No, there's no way. Yeah, there's no way in this world I'm going to be able to make it now. He's too far ahead of me. He's already got such a huge... lead on me. He's right frickin' there. Yeah, you lost. Doppelganger reached the goal first. I might not even get through all the challenges for Act 1. And the doppelgangers seem to follow the same path, so you don't have to worry about, the paths being randomly generated each time you do the challenge. you know, so that makes it a little bit easier. If you can learn the movements of the doppelganger, you can learn where he's going, where he doesn't, and you can actually gain quite a bit of time on him like that. And as I've said before, you know, this game will track your time when you go through checkpoints, so you can kind of tell how much faster you're going through a section. And obviously, the next checkpoint I trip, I'm going to go a lot freaking slower. Yeah, nearly 10 seconds slower. Wow. I'd love to have those 10 seconds back, but maybe I can gain a little bit of time through here. No, there's no time to be gained through there. You see, this level is just not geared for classic Sonic. Everything about a Rooftop Run was never made to be a classic Sonic level. It was always supposed to be a modern Sonic level. It was never, ever meant for this kind of crap. And so, you know, why Sega would even do this for, I don't even understand. But it just goes back to the challenges, you know? If the challenges weren't here, you wouldn't have to put up with this crap. Try to figure out where that section is. I can gain quite a bit of time on it, and I don't even remember where that is, so I probably won't make it. Oh, come on. Okay, well, he's already so far ahead of me, it doesn't even frickin' matter. Come on, what the fuck? Alright, still got the clock tower. If I can get to the clock tower fast enough, I can... Yeah, 32 seconds, wow. I can get through the clock tower section faster than him, and I doubt I can. He's got such a huge lead on me. But if I can get through that section faster than him, I can maybe, just maybe, pull this off, and I doubt I can. You can already tell. You can kind of tell where he is already. And I'm not gaining near enough time. I think I might have gained 3 seconds there. I'm not sure how the timing is, like if they cut off each level in sections, or if it's just your overall time, you know, compared to the last time you played. And I'm thinking that's what it is. You know, it's not individual sector times, it's overall. This is, you know, you're doing 30 seconds slower than you did the first time you came through here, or the last time you came through here. See if I can screw this up again. Oh, come on, you fucking piece of... Alright. Alright, I'm gonna go see if I can get that lightning shield. Using the double jump through here will definitely help me save quite a bit of time. While trying to do this, there's no way I'm going to be able to do all the challenges. The best I can hope for is that I can get this doppelganger race, and I'm only going to give it one more try. If I can't, then I'll just beat it off screen. You know, there's nothing special to it. You've already seen all the other doppelganger races. Like I said, you've already seen the end of this level. Nothing special, nothing important. Okay. Thunder Shield. We'll get you a Thunder Shield. Yeah. Skill customization. Oh. I didn't have the power break in there. And then the Thunder Shield. Alright. And if as I've said before, and I believe part one, the check mark should mean that it's able for me to equip. And so I'll just head back here. Let me see, how do I get back up there? Okay, let me think about that one a second. And now, I don't believe Supersonic would actually help me out. I just thought about that. I don't believe they would let you play as Supersonic through the challenges. I'll be lucky if they'll even let me use the shield or the break on the challenges. Okay, well, I'm just sitting here, just sitting here waiting, hoping. Maybe they won't. Crap. Okay, so they did. So they didn't. It. You, as I said before, you would have it at the start of the challenge or of the level, instead of it wouldn't be something that you could obtain later on. You would have it right at the start, and it would be your job to either keep it or you'd have to die and go back to your checkpoint to get it again. I'm doing okay. 6 seconds better than three there. I think I was like 3/100ths of a second. Come on. I think I was three hundredths of a second better. Alright. This will be the last time. I won't cut again, or I won't start over again. If I make it, I make it. If I don't, then I'll just do it off camera. I'll tell you whatever prize I got from the bell, and then in part 12, I'll just do the rest of the challenges here for Classic Sonic, Modern Sonic, and then I'll do Planet Wisp. Gained quite a bit of time doing that. 0.7 seconds, so they got it from the last time I was through there. Which is okay. I'm still 6 seconds faster than I was my first time going through here. Whenever it's green, that means we're doing good, and I'm just happy to see the green. It's debatable to wait through this section. Well, that was stupid, but no, the platform was gonna fall on me anyway, and it got me to that middle section where I really needed to be. Anyway, so. Still doing okay, not nearly as fast as I could be. I'm definitely slowing down a little bit. And there you go, 0.2 tenths of a second faster. I'll try to go on the upper path. The upper path will obviously be a little bit, it'll be a lot faster, but it's just, whether I can or not. That's the big thing. If I can get up there, great. If I can't, like that, then I'm stuck on the bottom section. But I know where I'm supposed to be going now. If I can quit taking damage on egg fighters, they hardly hit you in Sonic Unleashed. You almost felt bad if you got hit by them. You have got to be kidding me. And maybe I used the spin jump or the spin dash thing in the wrong area. Or maybe I wasn't supposed to use it on the platform. Now that I think about it, yeah, I shouldn't have used it on the platform. I should have got off the platform and then used it. Doppelganger, sadly, doesn't seem to be doing nearly as bad as me. I don't know why I can't make that jump for whatever. Well, yeah, no, I know why I can't make that jump. Because of how slow this game is. Or how crappy the jumping is in this game. But I'll head along this lower section. I know I can make it past this. I've done it before. There's no way to actually... Well, I don't know of any way to break that and to get by here like this. Come on, let me down. Able to gain a little bit of time on the... Oh, a minute, 5 seconds slower. I gained a little bit of time on the doppelganger, thankfully. So it would seem that the higher section actually is a little bit faster.
Alright.
I'm not even going to worry about the time, you know, it's because I kept dying through that section back there, and because the clock doesn't restart to when you last hit a checkpoint, that's why it keeps saying a minute slower like that. Okay. I'm not going to be overly optimistic because I've still got the clock hands to go and through in this section, obviously. You know, hey, why not? Alright, come on. And this is where it all goes to pot, and I lose all the time that I had saved. And there's the doppelganger. What do you know? Alright, that works. It works. I'm happy. The doppelganger seems to be really screwing up, so I don't care. And I'm going to get a D, but you know, that's kind of what I deserve. And I'm home free, so I'm just going to get... Thankfully. Yes. Happy. Happy, happy. As long as my capture didn't record, I'll be even happier. Or as long as my capture didn't mess up, like the sound and everything didn't lag behind, I'll definitely be happier than that. But I'm going to go ahead and end the video here, rapidly running out of time. I do apologize. I will finish it all in part 12 for sure, no matter what. You know, there will be no question to that. I will. Well, I can't. I keep sitting here thinking, you know, yeah, you know, I can do that. I can get it and everything, but I just don't know, you know, the time-wise, you know, maybe it'll just take me way too long, and I won't be able to do it in one video, but I'll definitely try. But anyway, so thank you for watching. Won't be a challenge video, because this is a challenge video, not an actual main story video, so until part 12, later,